Let's now create our photos table. Creating this table will generally look similar to our users, but we're going to also add in a foreign key column. So let's get to it. Back over here, I'm going to delete that query we had written out, and I will replace it with a create table photos. Inside of here, we want to have an ID column. Its type will be serial, and we want it to serve as a primary key for the table. Again, we're going to go into what primary key means a little bit later on inside the course. Then after that, we're going to add in our URL for the photo. I'll give it a varchar of how about 200. The URL right here is supposed to serve as a link to where this photo is stored. We're going to not really be working with any actual photos, so we'll put in some dummy data for this URL. Nonetheless, if it was going to serve a real URL, we might give it a length of 200 just to make sure it could store some really long URL. Then after that, we're going to add in our foreign key. We're going to call this column UserID, and it will contain a type of integer. We are not going to use that same serial that we used for the ID column over here on users, because if we mark UserID as serial, that means Postgres is going to try to assign a value to it for us automatically, and we don't want that. We want to be able to specify exactly what user provided a given photo. So we're going to create UserID, we're going to mark it as integer, and then we're going to add on one additional little piece of syntax when we create this column, and that additional little piece is what's going to turn this column into a foreign key column. So we're going to put in here user ID. It's of type integer, and then here's the magic part. We're going to write out references, then the name of the table that we're going to reference with this foreign key, its users, and then the column inside of that table that we want to reference in particular, which is ID. All right, so user ID, let's just walk through this very quickly, is going to contain integers that are going to reference some rows inside the user's table. And the row that we are trying to reference is going to match up to the ID column. The user's ID right here is saying this column is going to try to reference something inside the user's table, specifically the values inside of this ID column. That's what that last little piece says. So what does it really mean to mark a column as being a foreign key? Well, as you can see very quickly, it enforces some level of data consistency. Right now, that probably doesn't make a lot of sense. So let's just create this table, and then you'll start to see what marking this column as a foreign key really does for us. All right, so I'm going to run this query. Our table has been created. I'm going to insert into photos. I'm going to only provide a URL and a user ID, because once again, our ID for the photo will be automatically generated. We'll then provide some values. For this first photo, we'll just do one single photo, unlike users, where we put in four users at once. I'm going to put in some kind of fake URL here. So I'll put in, how about http://1.jpg. Definitely not really a valid URL, but it doesn't matter. And then finally, as a second value, we're going to specify which user this photo is associated with. So how about for the first one, we do exactly what it says over here. I want my first image, my first photo, to be associated with the user with ID4. So we're going to set up a relationship like that right there. So to set that up, I'll put in a 4, and that should be it. So I'll run that query, and that row has been inserted. Awesome. Let's now select all the different photos. Well, I guess the one photo that is in that table right now. So I'll do a select star from photos. I'll run that, and we've definitely got it in there. All right, so at this point, well, we've got a 4 there, but who cares, right? What does that really do for us? Well, there's two big things that we get by adding in this foreign key. First off, we can start to write a lot of interesting queries that allow us to fetch all the different photos that are associated with a given user. We also start to get a little bit of what we call data consistency, and that's a term that I used just a moment ago. Let's take a pause here. When we come back in the next video, we'll start to learn how we can write some queries to fetch all the photos that were created by a given user, and then we'll start to also figure out what it really means to have some consistency in our data.